हाय गाइस, तो इस वीडियो में हम डिस्कस करेंगे भाई मोनोपोली की वैल्यूएशन, उसकी परफॉर्मेंस की वैल्यूएशन। और जब हम बात करेंगे परफॉर्मेंस वैल्यूएशन की, तो हमें देखना होगा कि भाई क्या वो फैक्टर्स हैं जिसकी वजह से अगर हम उनको कंसिडर करें, तो अगर ये फैक्टर्स एग्जिस्ट करते हैं तो ज़रूरी नहीं है कि भाई मोनोपोलीज जो हैं वो हमेशा अनडिज़ायरेबल होती हैं। और वैल्यूएशन का मतलब खाली यार उसकी एडवांटेजेस और डिसएडवांटेजेस के ऊपर बात करना नहीं होता है। वैल्यूएशन दिस इज़ एनालिसिस। अगर आप बात करें एडवांटेजेस की और डिसएडवांटेजेस की, तो एडवांटेजेस और डिसएडवांटेजेस को हम इकोनॉमिक्स में एनालिसिस कह रहे होते हैं, दैट इज़ डीप एनालिसिस, ठीक है ना। बट इवैल्यूएशन गोज वन स्टेप फर्दर देन दिस एंड इट टॉक्स अपॉन थिंग्स लाइक इफ दीज फैक्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट, सो यू नो द स्टेटमेंट दैट द एग्जामिनर इज मेड विल नॉट एग्जिस्ट। बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली क्वेश्चंस जो एग्जाम में आ रहे होते हैं वो आ रहे होते हैं, सो टू व्हाट एक्सटेंट डू यू एग्री, कंसिडर व्हाई यू एग्री वेदर और नॉट, और डू यू एग्री, टू व्हाट एक्सटेंट डू यू एग्री, क्रिटिकली इवैल्यूएट, यू नो स्टफ लाइक दैट, डिस्कस क्वेश्चंस स्पेशली 13-25 मार्क्स। तो वहाँ पे एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट स्किल है जो बच्चों में होनी चाहिए, एंड दैट इज़ अबाउट इवैल्यूएशन। तो गाइस, इवैल्यूएशन जो है ना, दैट इज़ समथिंग जो आपके इकोनॉमिक्स के एग्जाम का बहुत कोर कंपोनेंट, आपके आंसर का कोर कंपोनेंट है, ठीक है। सो इवैल्यूएशन का बेसिकली मतलब ये होता है कि आप एग्जामिनर को किसी पर्टिकुलर चीज़ पे लेकर आना चाह रहे हैं, उसको अपनी बात एम्फसाइज कर रहे हैं, और आप चाहते हैं एग्जामिनर इस पॉइंट को ध्यान में रखे कि आप क्या कहना चाह रहे हैं। मिसाल के तौर पर भाई मोनोपोलीज़ ऑब्वियसली हर दफ़ा तो पब्लिकली अनडिज़ायरेबल नहीं होती ना। माना कि मोनोपोलीज़ के डिसएडवांटेजेस हैं, बट हर दफ़ा तो नहीं होंगी ना। और हमने ये भी माना कि मोनोपोलीज़ के एडवांटेजेस हैं, लेकिन इवैल्यूएशन के अंदर हम उसके एडवांटेजेस नहीं बता रहे, हम उसके मोनोपोली के फ़ायदे नहीं बता रहे। हम ये बात करेंगे इवैल्यूएशन में कि अगर ये फैक्टर्स एग्जिस्ट करते हैं तो मोनोपोलीज़ ख़राब नहीं होंगी, राइट। सो द फैक्ट दैट मोनोपोलीज़ आर हार्मफुल, द फैक्ट दैट मोनोपोलीज़ मे बी हार्मफुल, that fact will not exist if these factors are present. And what are those factors? So what if the first factor says heavily regulated, which means ki what if the industry the where the monopoly is operating is heavily regulated by the government. Agar government usko heavily regulate kar rahi hai, properly regulate kar rahi hai, price controls lagaye hue hain, quality measures lagaye hue hain, maybe the government ne koi law pass kiya hua hai where it has forced the monopolies to actually reinvest all those supernormal profits or maximum supernormal profits that it has earned back into the business, into research and development, and obviously that would result into allocative and productive efficiencies, right? It would be in the best interest for the consumers as well as the market and the society, and so in that sense monopolies won't be harmful. Then maybe it might, if monopolies are reinvesting back the profits into research and development, investing in technology and innovation, it would result into dynamic efficiency. And dynamic efficiency, we have already studied that it's part of productive efficiency that happens in the long run, where your long run average cost curve shifts downwards, right? It reduces. Aapki long run average cost shift kar deti hai niche ki taraf, which means that aapki average cost jo hai firms ki fall ho gayi. So whatever output the firm was producing initially, so the same output is now going to be produced at a much lower average cost of production, and those cost benefits that the monopoly firm will have obviously will be transferred. We'll assume that they may be transferred, or at least they will be to an extent transferred to consumers in the form of much lower prices and a much higher output, again resulting into higher consumer surpluses, resulting into even the producer surpluses would, we can argue that they would also rise in the sense that, you know, more output will be produced. So definitely, maybe we can argue that more profit for monopolies as well. So don't think just because prices are falling, the monopoly profits would fall. No, because here the cost is falling as well, right? So even if the prices will fall, still monopolies would be earning, we can say, good amount of profits, right? We can assume that in this sense. So the point is that the fact is that dynamic efficiency would result into falling long run average cost, which would be beneficial for consumers and more desirable for public interest as well. The third case, you would argue that what if the monopoly is a natural monopoly? So if natural monopoly hai, to phir usme competition ki zarurat nahi hai na, because agar natural monopoly hoti hai, so it's better that monopoly, that particular industry is supplied by that single natural monopoly. It makes more sense, because agar usme competition aa jayega, तो कंपटीशन हम ये भी कह सकते हैं, बिकॉज हर जगह कंपटीशन अच्छा नहीं होता। कुछ ऐसी इंडस्ट्रीज़ होती हैं, कुछ ऐसी मार्केट्स होती हैं जहाँ पर अगर वो प्रोडक्ट एक सिंगल फर्म ही सप्लाई करिए तो वो बेहतर है, बिकॉज कंपटीशन के आने से रिसोर्सेज का, हम कह सकते हैं, वेस्ट है, ज़ाया है रिसोर्सेज का। सो अगेन, बिकॉज कुछ ऐसे स्ट्रेटेजिक इंडस्ट्रीज़ होती हैं, कुछ की इंडस्ट्रीज स्ट्रेटेजिक इंडस्ट्रीज फॉर द कंट्री, So it's argued that it's more beneficial that those industries are supplied by one single firm, right? So अगर natural monopoly है तो फिर उसको natural monopoly रहने दें because it's more beneficial and plus उससे resources आए नहीं होंगे because competition would just result into duplication. And duplication would result into wasteful duplication, you can say. Waste ho rahe honge resources. In that sense, you can argue that if it's a natural monopoly, it makes more sense ke bhai competition usme na ho. But again, the fact is ke wo natural monopoly bhi regulated honi chahiye. You know, aisa nahi ho ke natural monopoly mein exploitation ho rahi ho. If it's regulated, it will result into more allocatively efficient outcomes and hence will be in the best interest of society and would increase welfare, right? So again, another point that we can make is कि अगर firms reinvest कर रहे हैं अपने profits, so obviously उनको economies of scale हो रहा होगा, where an economies of scale होता है, so obviously the more economies of scale we have, हमें जितने ज़्यादा economies of scale होगा, so उतना ज़्यादा we would be able to exploit our economies of scale and hence the more we would be able to produce at a much lower point on our average cost curve, right? On this average cost curve. So, utna zyada hum, you know, we will be producing at a much lower point on the average cost curve and we will be producing much closer to the MES. So, since this is the MES, that is the minimum efficient scale, and at the minimum efficient scale, all our economies of scale are exploited and exhausted, right? So, jitna close hum uske honge MES ke, utna zyada humari cost of production jo hogi, wo kam hogi, utni zyada humari average cost kam hogi. And if you are producing at an output that is beyond MES, so hume diseconomies ho raha hoga, that would be disadvantages for consumers because obviously it would reduce the consumer surplus and consumer welfare because obviously diseconomies of scale ke andar the cost is rising, so monopolies would be charging higher prices, right? So and that would result into productive inefficiency. So as far as monopolies are making good economies of scale, if they're taking the advantage of that economies of scale and hence producing at a much lower average cost, then that's a good thing. It would result into productively efficient outcomes, right? So another thing that we could also argue is that sometimes profit maximization is not the sole objective of all monopolies. So what if the objective is, let's say, sales maximization, right? If they say we want to maximize sales, what if the objective is to be allocatively efficient? Or what if the objective is to have a corporate social responsibility just for the seeking improving goodwill of the business and brand reputation among the masses, right? So in that sense, we could argue that it depends. So whether monopolies are harmful or not also depends upon the current objective. If the current objective might not be profit maximization, so how can we say that monopolies are always harmful, right? So current objective might be corporate social responsibilities. That would be in the best interest of society and it would be more desirable and it would be beneficial for the public interest, right? But again, obviously, corporate social responsibility cannot be an objective in the long run, right? The monopolies will ultimately resort to profit maximization. But resorting to profit maximization does not mean exploitation, right? Also, keep that in mind. However, it does to an extent, yes, it does. But again, to an extent, it does not. And that is what we're evaluating in the exam. And that is all about evaluation. And one more very solid argument that you guys can make in the exam is solid evaluation is that what if the monopoly market is a contestable market? If a contestable market is, then the tension is not there. Even the government regulation or government intervention in the monopoly market is not necessary in that sense. Why? Because if a contestable market is, so the mere threat of contestability, the fact that it's a contestable market, although it's a monopoly in that market, but still the market dynamics is that it's a contestable market. So that the threat of competition or the threat that a firm will come and, you know, take away all its dominance, that threat will act as actual competition. Although there is no competition, that's a threat of competition, but again the fact that there's a threat might act as actual competition, and hence monopolies would not exploit, and hence they would try to be as allocatively efficient as possible. So again you can argue that as well. Again, एक बात बहुत जहन में रखिएगा कि जस्ट बिकॉज आपकी जो फर्म है वो मोनोपली है एक पर्टिकुलर मार्केट में, इसका मतलब है कि उसके पास हो सकता है 25% के 25 से ज़्यादा उसके पास मार्केट शेयर है. तो अगर किसी फर्म के पास 25% मिनिमम मार्केट शेयर है, सो वी कुड आर्ग्यू दैट फर्म इज डोमिनेंट इन द मार्केट, राइट? उसकी डोमिनेंस है, वो मोनोपली है. बट जस्ट बिकॉज वो मोनोपली है, इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि वो सिंगल फर्म भी है उस पर्टिकुलर मार्केट में, उसके पास कॉम्पिटिशन हो सकता है. सो द रिमेनिंग 75% ऑफ द मार्केट माइट बी distributed among other small or maybe other firms who are not a monopoly, but still they might be providing competition to the monopoly. Not huge competition, but still small competition can also force the monopolies to at least try to be close to being productively or allocatively efficient, or at least you know, trying close to be, you know, producing an outcome or output or charging a price that is in the best interest for society and the public interest, right? So ye evaluation hoti hai, is tarike se exam mein evaluate karna hota hai. You don't have to just give advantage and disadvantage, aur is tarah agar aap ye skill seekhenge to definitely you will score those bomb marks in exam. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. This was a good learning video for you all. So inshallah I'll see you all in the next video. Till then, take care.